could be any of those people with the emperor at the bottom of the deck. Somebody is somebody finna get new love. Okay, with the emperor at the bottom of the deck, somebody is very much like a boss. This is the boss. This the boss. This the real boss. This not the everybody else. They just regular Joes. They regular kings, you know, not to be saying it like that, but that's what I'm saying. This the big boss. This the big man right here. Okay? Somebody's reaching out. Or organization, you know what I'm saying, is reaching out to you. Okay, I use that deck. Okay, as I continue, I'm going to, okay, I'm gonna do this. This is the Archangel Power Tarot deck. Power tarot deck. Okay. God is intervening. God stepping in. God says time. It's time. Now is the time. Okay? That's what I'm seeing here. To reunite, to work together, to come together as a team with some people or something like that. Or opportunity to come in. It's now is the time. Okay? Let's see what's up. Somebody's worried. They have nothing to worry about. Somebody's finna send somebody a message. Okay? Because they worry a person maybe not want to mess with them or talk to them anymore. Yeah. Because what I'm seeing here is there's an opportunity coming in, something new. So it's like now you could be free. You could do what you want to do. Somebody a little afraid. They holding back a little bit. Okay. So somebody's reaching out to somebody. Somebody from the past or a friend. They want to make peace, reconcile, is what I'm seeing here. This could be somebody that you message or talk to on the phone. You having a real conversation with this person. Yeah, this is about some healing, okay? Somebody seeing something from a different perspective, okay? We got the Queen of Ariel here coming out. This is about you taking care of yourself. You nurturing yourself. You take care of the people that you love. You on your shit. You a boss in your own way. You know what I'm saying? You are good with your finances, your resources, okay? This is telling you that, yes, it's okay for you to take care of yourself, okay? I'm also seeing here is somebody is watching you and seeing that you the shit, fam. That you fine. You the shit. You know what I'm saying? We got the Nine of Ariel here. I'm gonna take my glasses off because, yeah. I did my own makeup, y'all. We got the Two of Ariel here. So somebody's doing what they love to do. You're feeling good, you're doing what you love to do, you're finding a healthy balance. That's what's up, you know. You may get an opportunity to do what you love to do. The Nine of Ariel, that's a woman who's on her shit. She a boss. She taking care of herself. She got everything she need. You know what I'm saying? Car, house. She looks good. If she has children, her children are taken care of. Okay, you got money saved up. Somebody's watching you and they seeing this. And you looking real good is what I'm saying here. Okay? That's fact. So with love though, you got the Nine of Wands. You want to give up. Why do I always laugh when I hear certain stuff? It's like when there's certain stuff, it's like, I don't know, it's just funny. Because you want to give up on love. It's like you ready to give up on love. Yeah. Queen of Swords. It's like you going, you don't care. Damn. It ain't, oh wow. Yeah, because you a boss on your own, so you don't need nobody. It's like I be trying to love people, man. And love don't be acting right. So you know what? I just want to get my business together, cut off these burdens, these cycles. Yeah, when it comes to love, you've been dealing with some shit. It's what I'm seeing here, yeah. And somebody come back around and I feel like you find it, or somebody is your friend and things start to move forward and you find them a challenge, you're like, nah, I gotta cut your ass off. But there's Ace of Cups here, okay? If somebody's sending you a message, okay? They come up with a solution. Maybe this person wants to be with you because we got the King of Aries, or they want to work with you or be friends with you or something like that. I don't know. We got the Two of Cups, and another card up in here is turned over as well. The Ten of Swords. So I feel like you're now wrapping up a toxic cycle, fam. Maybe somebody was trying to get over on you and you like, or you was worried about somebody trying to get over on you and you like, you know what? We could just be friends. That's what it's like. I just thought, like, you know what? We could just be friends, okay? And then somebody comes in that's like a soulmate or partner or something like that, or you and this person together are choosing to get away from the negativity. If you were in a relationship with somebody and y'all just was going through some arguing or some stuff like that, and things are now getting better is what I'm seeing here. I feel like you and somebody are meant to be y'all meant to build an empire together. Or y'all are going to be very wealthy, stable, be able to retire early in life. You know what I'm saying? Because it says there's so much to be grateful for, financial success and a promise of retirement, a rich and rewarded family life with the Ten of Pentacles. You already at the nine. It's like if somebody else comes, that's a plus. That's another blessing. I guess if they in a right space, if they in the right place in their mind and in their life, you know what I'm saying? Because other than that, it's a burden. You know what I'm saying? We got the King of Raphael coming out. So it's saying that you could trust this person, whoever this is. This is Nine of Cups. This may be somebody you wish for, hope for. Not even that. It's like with this card right here, the feelings are mutual. This some crazy shit right here. The feelings are mutual. You and the person not talking right now, but the person is going to talk to you. Why are we going to the love stuff? Maybe all this pink I got on. Yeah, it do bring in type of energy. That's crazy. But yeah, this wish fulfillment, Nine of Cups at the bottom of the deck, okay? This saying make a wish, dreams become reality, a joyful time. So maybe at a point in time this person is the one making a wish. Maybe you both wish for each other or something. Maybe you don't even know each other though, and then y'all come to each other, okay? No, somebody wants to talk about something or something that was like, somebody didn't get away with some BS. Somebody making a choice to work. Why just like... Okay, somebody stood up for themselves. They didn't allow somebody to do them wrong or something like that. You know, you reject somebody. Sometimes it's like when somebody is not the right person for you, or they not in the right space or whatever place for you, okay? You know, them coming towards you would be a test, you know? And some you can indulge with those people, but I feel like you gotta know when enough is enough. And I feel like that's what you was on. I feel like the passion was still burning with you and somebody, but you feel like they not the right one for you. So you may have said no to this person's advance or something that between you and this person, and that bring in somebody that is actually way better for you, okay? That's what I'm seeing here with somebody. So it's the end of being left out in the cold, because this Five of Pentacles here kind of came out in reverse, Five of Aries. Okay, so I feel like somebody's realizing it's better to work together. If you don't gotta do stuff alone, then you don't gotta do stuff alone. Somebody's taking action because they want to be happy, they want to be successful. Is what I'm seeing here. Okay. Somebody's leaving some friends or leaving a third party. Somebody's cut somebody off. Yeah, because this is Three of Swords at the bottom of the deck. It's time to let the past go. God is stepping in. The things are transforming and turning in your life. Like I just said, somebody is leaving the Five of Pentacles. And this the end of poverty. This the end of dealing with low vibrational energy people and stuff like that. This the end of doing things on your own and not having any help as well, is what I'm seeing here. This is letting go of friends and stuff and people who can't even help you or offer you nothing when you're going through stuff as well. They just sitting around you and stuff like that for your good times, and when you're in your bad times, they not even there. They can't even give you good advice with this Five of Pentacles up in reverse, you know what I'm saying? So, but the thing about it is that's all changing. You know, there's some healing coming in with the Star, the Queen of Cups, the Star card, and the, yeah, you've been hurt in the past and you've been holding this time to let it go. You have. So what I'm seeing here is the Ten of Pentacles is coming out. It's coming out. So somebody's going to be very, very wealthy, successful. This is something that you put hard work and effort into. You constantly do with something or do things to bring wealth to your life, and that's what it is. Or this, you know, recognizing that you are very blessed and you being appreciative of all the things that you already have, because that's the 10, like I said, and it went to the from the 9 to the 10, you know what I'm saying? I feel like you was alone, and you know how sometimes when people alone, they feel alone, they don't take stock of their blessings, but you alone and you know how blessed you are, so you're not sitting around like missing nobody or nothing like that. That's a good thing, you know what I'm saying? So then something stable, solid comes in, and it's that when God say the will, and this is something that's meant to be. This is something that nobody can stop. This is something, this is God's timing. Okay, I'm gonna leave it at there, because my advice is to let go of the past. Don't allow the past to get in the way of the future. Okay, try to see the bigger picture in a situation. Okay, when it comes, whether that's with business or family member or a lover that's coming towards you, somebody that you never yeah, because somebody was trying to do some very underhanded stuff and they now realizing that it's wild. It's no, I don't know, like nothing good come out of it. Nothing good come out of it. But you see what I'm saying? You can't have everything, happiness, blessings, fulfilling your life if you take a certain step. That's what I'm seeing here. Somebody's going to reach out to somebody. But we're going to go ahead to the Work Your Light Oracle. I'm going to get ready to close the reading out. You know, I hope y'all doing good for real life. I feel good still. I still feel good, okay? So that's a good thing, you know. So it's Friday, you know. Feel good. Dance. Be safe. Those who need healing, I send blessings and healing your way. God, take care of those who need help at this time. It says, what is not aligned in your life and what needs to change? Somebody needs to come out of persecution, come out of the cave. Don't be afraid to express yourself, to talk about the stuff that's happened to you that's bad, you know what I'm saying, that's not, you know, that type of stuff or whatever the case. Even not even that, like if you got some shit to talk about, talk about it. Like, don't let anybody stop you or anything hold you back, okay, from being yourself, from speaking your truth, from being you, from doing you. This reminded me of the first card that came out, though. One of the first cards is like, says life review. So that's the same thing as that. You need to pay attention, look over your life, and see what needs to change. Okay? So somebody, it says double mission, channeling energy and uplifting humanity. At the bottom of the deck, we got Starseed. What lights you up? Okay? What lights you up? Okay, so with channeling energy can help you get more energy, better energy. And if you using it to uplift humanity, that's a good thing. So you need to stay grounded. You need to do things that make you happy, because that's what brings in more high vibration. That makes your vibration rise, feeling loved, feeling happy. So surround yourself with those type of things. Get yourself grounded. It says empaths. So there's some empathic people out there watching me, highly sensitives. It says connect with nature. Okay, that's how you, that's something that you can do to help yourself connect with nature. It says somebody may be longing for home or belonging to the original light workers. Okay, so you're not really feeling in. This is funny shit. Okay, so you don't really fit in around people because you shine very, very bright and you're a light worker, but your spirit is ancient. And so, why? Oh my God, why I'm laughing? It's not funny. Okay. Okay. Maybe it's funny to me because, okay, I felt like that a lot in life, okay? I felt outcasted a lot in life, and a lot I was. I was picked on. I'm very dark-skinned, you know what I'm saying? A lot growing up and stuff like that. So I would get picked on for my skin color and stuff. I always felt like I was beautiful and stuff. But people always would, whatever. You know, that type of stuff. So I would be by myself, but I would want to be by myself. So it's funny to me because it ain't funny at all, but it's like I always been the one to do the opposite. It could hurt my feelings. It could make me sad, but stuff that would make me sad sometimes would make me angry and make me uproar. You know, it would make me lash out. Things that like that. It's like sadness. I didn't handle sadness well. You know what I'm saying? So, and if it's like, it was like, if they don't like me, now I don't like them. You know, it was more like that. It was like, I would take on the energy that's there. It's like, keep that energy. I'm going to give you that energy back. That's the truth. I wasn't always like that, but it started very, very young. I learned very, very young. You know what I'm saying? I guess that, you know, everybody ain't your friend. You know what I'm saying? And I don't know why I'm saying that, but maybe that's somebody that, because they don't feel like they don't feel like they fit in too many places. You know what I'm saying? It says, but you are not alone. We got keepers of the earth here. Ancient ancestors stand beside you as well. We got to answer the call. What is your soul calling you to do? Soul family, calling your tribe. You don't have to do it alone. So it's like you're not even here alone. You just feel like it because you ain't really connected to your people yet. Okay? And I said, yeah. So maybe that matters. Okay? So I'm going to go ahead and wrap this reading up. Y'all take care of yourselves. Everybody take care of themselves. Have a blessed weekend. Kiss your kids. Hug your kids. Love your kids. Yourself as well. Okay? Last message, something popped out before I end it. It says, what is your soul calling you to do? Like I said. And it got the ever unfolding rose. It says, not happening to you. It's happening for you. So remember that. Okay? Know that. You might not like what's going on, but it's not. It's like God working, okay? So you may not be getting everything you want and stuff like that, but no, everything's going to be okay. So with that being said, I'm going to go ahead and end this reading. Y'all take care of yourselves.